Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I am going to show you how to add UI components to the Blazor Dashboard Layout component, how to arrange the panels using the CellSpacing property, and customize the look of the dashboard using the CssClass property. Then, I will also explain floating panels and responsive and adaptive layouts functionality of the dashboard. If you want to know how to get started with the Blazor dashboard in a Blazor WebAssembly application, check the video link given in the YouTube card above or in the description below. Let me start adding UI components to the Blazor dashboard in my existing Blazor application. This application has a Blazor dashboard layout with four panels and a simple content. I will run this application. See the dashboard layout with four panels. Okay, now look at this image. This is a dashboard layout that represents data visualization of income, expenses, and transactions over a period of 6 months. This layout has seven panels. The first four panels display information about total income, expenses, balance, and transactions made. Here is a Blazor spline area chart component that visualizes the income and expenses for 6 months. The pie chart visualizes the total expenses made in different categories. And the Blazor grid component shows details of transactions like transaction ID, category of expense, mode of payment, and amount of transaction. First, I will show you how to design the skeletal layout of this dashboard. I navigate to the index.razor page. As there are seven panels in the sample dashboard layout, I add three more panels here. Then, I name the panels appropriately. In order to generate the defined layout, I have customized the columns property, column and row positions, size X and size Y dimensions for each panel and set appropriate values. To know more about these properties, check the Blazor Dashboard Layout Getting Started video linked in the above YouTube card. I save the changes and run the application. Here you see the skeletal layout of the sample dashboard. Next, I will start adding content to the panels. Let me first design the four panels that display information about income, expenses, balance, and transactions. I replace the existing title of the first panel with income. Then I replace the content with an HTML table element. Within the table, I have a paragraph tag and an image tag to display the total income value. Next, I repeat the same for the other three panels. I replace the title and then the respective content. Here, I customize the style of these paragraph elements with the corresponding CSS styles by adding the classes Income Container and Expense Container. Then, I added styles to those classes within the style tag. For better alignment of the images, I added margin styles to them using the style attribute. I save the changes and run the application. Look at the dashboard. The first four panels display the total income, expenses, balance, and transactions made. Here, for demonstration purpose, I've used fictitious data. You can use real data as per your requirement. Next, I am going to add chart and grid components to the dashboard layout. For that, I need to install the respective NuGet packages into my application. I open NuGet Package Manager by right-clicking the project and choosing Manage NuGet Packages option. I install Syncfusion Blazor Charts first. Then, the Syncfusion Blazor Grid package. When the installation is complete, I navigate to imports.razor page and import charts and grid namespaces. I navigate to index.razor page. As a next step, I replace the title of panel 5 as income expenses. Within the content template, I add the Blazor spline area chart by copying the code snippet from our demo application and pasting it here. Inside the @code directive, I maintain different data sets for charts and grid components. This is the data set for spline chart. This is for pie chart. And this one is for the grid component. As I told you earlier, I use fictitious data here for demonstration. Here, I've bound values to the spline area chart using the datasource property. I've defined the properties like name, xname, yname, chart type, and fill properties as per the requirement. Next, I replace the title of panel 6 with total expenses. And, I add the Blazor pie chart by copying the code snippet from our demo application and pasting it here. I've bound values to the chart using the datasource property. I've defined the properties like xname, yname, radius, inner radius, start angle and end angle as per the requirement. I've also defined data label settings tag with appropriate settings. If you want to know the step-by-step definition of these charts code snippets, refer to the link given in the description below. I save the changes and run the application. The dashboard layout is rendered with a spline area chart and a pie chart. Next, I am going to add the grid component. Before that, I replace the title of panel 7 with recent transactions. As I have already installed the Blazor grid package and imported the namespace, I directly add the grid component by copying the code snippet from our demo application and pasting it here. I've bound values to the grid using the datasource property. I've defined all the required properties of the grid component. If you want to know the step-by-step explanation about this code snippet, check out the documentation link given in the description below. I save the changes and run the application. Look at the dashboard. It is rendered with the Blazor grid component. Now, I will show you how to define spacing in the layout. Looking at the dashboard now, the spacing between cells is less. To increase it, I use the CellSpacing property and set the desired value. Here, I set the spacing value as 10 pixels for the x-axis and 10 pixels for the y-axis. Look at the layout now, cell spacing is 10 pixels in rows and columns. Now, I would like to customize the look of the dashboard layout panels. As an example, I will show you how to set custom background color for the panel header. Within the style tag, I define the base classes ePanel, ePanel container, and ePanel header. I override the background color and text color of the panel header. See the custom background color applied to all the panel headers in the layout. If you want to customize the look of any one panel, use the CssClass option. Now, let me define the CssClass option for panel 1 and set the value to eCustom. Inside the style tag, I append the CCustom class with the base classes. Look at the dashboard now, the custom look is applied only to panel 1. Next, let us move on to the floating panel functionality. This is used for effective panel placement. For example, if I drag a panel and drop it somewhere in the layout, the adjacent panel will automatically float and occupy the empty space. Here, I have removed the CssClass property for panel 1, as I would like to apply background color for all panel headers. I enable the floating functionality by defining the allow floating property and setting its value to true. Look, when I drag panel 1 and panel 2 and drop them, panel 3 floats upwards automatically to occupy the place of panel 1 and panel 2. Next, I will show you how the dashboard component works as a responsive and adaptive layout. To demonstrate that, I define the media query property and set its value to 700 pixels. I will show the output in the tablet mode. Here, you can see the dashboard layout adapting itself to fit into the responsive layout when I change the resolution in the browser window. If you want, you can add additional CSS styles to the UI elements inside the style tag, based on the resolution value. Let me summarize what I have shown you so far. You saw how to add components to the dashboard layout, how to arrange the cells, and customize the look of the dashboard. You also saw the floating panel functionality and the adaptive responsive layout of the dashboard. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching the video.